in Black Beauty, driving down to Huntington Castle to see Olivia Robertson through Mass, through Kilcullen, now on the road to Dunleavin. I don't know where I'm going. It's great. It's been pouring rain, though. So I'll see you down the road as we listen to Ravel's Bolero. Hi, Mama. Hi, Catherine Heron, Henry Heron. Floodwaters. Help! What kind of a day is this? Just as well you guys run along. Would you look at this? Yay, Black Beauty. Smoking, huh? Why not? It's one of those days. Ah, out of the floods temporarily. See you again. Well, thank you. It made it to County Wicklow anyway. Okay, now we're out of Dunleavin, heading toward Belting Glass, or Belting Blast, on the N81. And then after that, it should take us into Tulo, or Tallow. And then you can take this side road off to Quantigal itself. Now, blasting gas is just about 10 miles down this road. So we'll see you down this road. Wow. Yeah, we arrived in Belting Glass, and we're heading now on the N81 to Tullo. And the rain keeps falling, folks. Mostly some pretty heavy squalls along the way, so. Wow. Yeah, here we are in the little town of Tullo. Have to go out here, down the main street, turn left, past a smar shop, and then turn left again. It's about 10 miles to Clonegal from here. That's about it. So I'll see you down the road, huh? Wish you were here, gang, but it's a lousy day. A lot of tears on the road, a lot of floods. And here we go again through another floodplain. Kicking up water on both sides again. Help! Rain and the rolling stones.
My soul turned to thee at the reception. A glass of wine in her hand. I knew she was gonna meet her connection. At her feet was a footloose man. You can't always get what you want. Woo-hoo! You can't always get what you want.
More flooded roads.
You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might find you get what you need.
Well, look at that sign, folks. How about that, huh? Nine clicks down that-a-way to Clonegal. So, see you down the road.
My sweet Lady J, when I see you again, your servant am I, and will humbly remain. Just heed this plea, my love. Unbended knees, my love. I pledge myself to Lady Jane. My dear Lady Anne, I've done what I can. I must take my leave, for promised I am. Is rough, my love. Your time has come, my love. I pledge my truth to Lady Jane.
And that's what that sign says. So we're entering Clonegal. Wow, huh? Look at this, folks. At about 11 o'clock in the morning, we reach Huntingdon Castle, huh? Isn't that amazing? Wow. Wow. And the rain's starting again. It stopped for about 5 minutes.
Where she came from.
Let's head on up the drive here.
Yesterday don't matter if it's gone. While the sun is bright, or in the darkest night, no one knows. And goes. Goodbye, Ruby Tuesday. Who could hang a name on you when you change with every new day? Still, I'm gonna miss you. Don't question why she needs to be so free. She'll tell you it's the only way to be.
Different than the last time, huh?
She just can't be chained to a life where nothing's gained and nothing's lost at such a cost. Who could hang a name on you when you change your name?
look familiar, everyone? Huh? Yeah, this is the door now that I'll be going into. I've already been with Olivia. In fact, she's got the video on and wanted very much to watch it. So I've left this door unlocked for myself here. Just push it open, I think. And I'll lock it from the inside. And we'll just go around to where I left Olivia. Just down here, we just had a cup of tea together as well, or a cup of coffee for me, rather. And here we go.
This is brilliant.
Yeah, you think so?
And
you
said, did anyone hear report or not?
I like his
UFO.
I've never heard that description before.
No. I thought it must be, because it's following the wind current and it's...
Mm-hmm.
Sail. Right.
It held its shape if it was a beast plastic.
You're doing me.
Right. In this sort of thing.
Of course.
Right. See that aspect, don't worry.
Wow.
Well, we're going out to lunch. We watched most of that video, as a matter of fact, Mary. And she's just going to get her coat and so on. I'm rewinding the video for her and enlightening her about the cover on this, okay? So, she wants to go out to lunch, so we're going out to lunch.
They are all relics. Hello.
Hello, Sarah. Sarah's taking on the tour job, I can see, huh?
Yeah.
How are you doing? Now you'll be on national television as well, as soon as this is edited. They'll say, why deny us being here? Is that what you're going
to
say?
Do you want to get written permission from all involved?
Absolutely not. No, we don't do that in the States.
Well, I think you should. I think it's a very good thing to do.
No, I'm just waiting for you. I suppose I should get a little bit of my own look today, huh? Mm-hmm. Whatever is being seen here. Okay, we are going out to lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Right. That's a courtyard we're familiar with, huh? Isn't that lovely? Very good. Standing by the door. Oh, really?
Yeah.
With the color, yes.
Yeah, with scarlet I go quite wild. It's the dark moon.
More of an Aries color, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. It's the dark moon I'm trying to come. This is a perfect color, you see.
I love that.
Good.
Which way are we going, Olivia?
I'll tell you. Let's get in the car and off we go.
Right.
Oh, look, photograph of it.
And now I have a genuine priestess in my house, and in my car and in my life, so this is really great. My wife is a priestess, and so is Olivia Robertson.
Well, yeah, I am, yes.
Oh, we're going out to lunch, Olivia.
Right.
So I'll see you down the road.
Right.
Don't leave town.
I mean, this is audio as well.
It is, of course.
Oh, I'll tell you about the story,
yes. Well, we're here at this restaurant. Close enough to home here, but I'm going to put this camera away. It's auto closed, just in case I have to stay a night, huh? And there's our friend over there. And the restaurant is right behind us, so we'll be going in, okay?
Okay.
We are, we're going in. Yes?
This is an ancient, very ancient...
Well, we're back at the castle here. After Olivia and I had dinner in town... We went Dutch, by the way, Mary. I had my first steak and baked potato in weeks. Very lovely chat. We really enjoyed it. Then we took a walk in a grotto and a garden. Took a long drive back to the castle. Doing a lot of chatting, and definitely she'd love to have the family here next Saturday, if we can, for the ceremony, okay, and to meet some more people. Tell you about that later. I'm just waiting for her to come back out. She took the cassette I brought into the house so she wouldn't forget it. She really loved that, you know. Absolutely adored that. So we'll wait for her to come out. All right. are you going to show me?
I think I'm going to show you the theatre.
Oh, really?
It's 18th century.
Not going to show me the ritual way, huh?
Oh, well, we're not doing the ritual.
That's for Saturday. We hope.
Right? You put your camera on. I don't mind.
Thank you. Well, we're in this building just off the courtyard here.
Mm.
Olivia says, this was the old theater.
There's the gallery.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
And don't you think the tapestries nice, the old theater?
Lovely, yes. They are old theater tapestries, all right.
There's a portrait of my brother. I painted him.
This one here?
No, this one.
I'm swinging around here.
Oh, well, that's my niece. There's David, the owner of the castle. This one. That awful looking one.
This awful looking one. Is That's David?
Yeah.
David is who now?
He's the owner of the castle now, David Durden Robertson.
And who's upstairs here?
Lucy, his sister.
I see. And?
There's a nice picture of Lucy, me painted by my sister Barbara. It's a portrait of me.
This is you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a sort of composite portrait of my brother that I did.
That's Lawrence.
Mm. It was a painting so hideous that I redid it.
How many times?
I didn't say that
for all right. Very nice.
So then we come along here.
Mm-hmm. We're following the priestess here. Oh, yes. Isn't this lovely?
This way. Now, that's new. You haven't seen that, have you?
No, I haven't, no. I haven't been in there.
There you are. Have a look at
that. Isn't that nice? New sculptures, aren't they?
More than nice. It's good.
Yes, as I say, it's good. It's beautiful.
There's Diana. There's Hector.
Mm-hmm.
She turned him into a stag because did he seduce a niece or chase it? No, he looked at one of her nymphs with no clothes on.
Terrible.
Mm-hmm. Of Peeping Tom.
Following around through this other adjacent courtyard after the sculpture.
Look, that's on the front, the red house. That's the old cow house.
Is it the old cow house?
Behind you.
Yeah? How's the old cow now? She's not going to... look at this, would you? The old cow house. Well, that could mean different things to different people.
This is chat show talk.
I know that. This is great entertainment value here.
Oh.
It's fantastic.
Oh.
Whoa. The last time I saw something like that, I had to pay admission.
It's a bit of a mess.
We're at the old orchard
done,
now,
you
folks.
See all these new paths all been done up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I'm really getting this guided tour here. This is lovely. Following in her footsteps is almost like walking in her shoes.
If you start being funny, I'm not going to say a word. Stop it.
You know better than that.
Oh, I can't bear it. No.
Now, where are we now?
I loathe funny dialogue.
Don't you?
I hate it. it turns me off.
Where are we now, Olivia?
Now.
Where's this path leading?
There is Mount Leinster there. That direction.
Okay.
And now we come down into the...
What's the name of this now?
Let's turn off and be spiritual.
Wow, this is a whole different visage as you come around the corner from that circular path there. Look at this, how this is laid out here.
Mm.
This is gorgeous. It fills you up with something, a whole different feeling affects you here. This is lovely. Wow. This is a path you haven't seen. Mare. Not at all.
I think what we'll do now is we'll leave this. I want to take you to the new walk.
Okay.
And I don't mind filming, but I'd like you to tune in as well. You'll miss everything.
I understand that. Attunement. I'm going for an attunement, Mary, so I'm going to turn this off for now, okay? We're going to do something special down this path.
Have you been here before?
No.
Really? As long as the human mind doesn't muck up the picture.
This is true.
Talk away by all means, you know. But
okay.
Not to entertain.
Well, we're going in between, dancing light between the tree brows, and just feeling your feet on this ground as you go down this grade.
This is the old wilderness here, leading right down to the grove of the oak, the dairy.
The druid oak. Path of the druids, really, the oakman.
Now, this is the yew walk. This is 600 years old, and ghostly monks and druids are meant to walk around here.
Wow.
You go ahead, because if you want to film it, you don't want me walking ahead, so...
You never know what you capture on film either, Olivia. Mm. You never know. We'll just take a little view here. And just keep your open psyches. Look at the branches here.
If they run into each other, you don't
notice. This is lovely, yeah.
Was once a double line of yews.
Look at this.
They're very Irish, these yew walks.
They are. Mm-hmm. My wife once wrote a poem called The Hill of the Yew Trees.
You're meant to get to an altered state by the time you get to the end.
Okay.
Wood pigeon.
You can hear it cooing.
I love it, don't you?
Look at this.
I'll take you now to our druid grove.
Wow. You know how we like gnarled trees and oaks and yews, don't you, Mary?
Right down to the river. I won't take you there.
And this is an axial line off of the yew tree line that we just came from.
Now this is a ginkgo tree, Salicifera antifolia, they call it, that one.
Uh-huh.
It's the oldest tree in the world.
Is it?
The oldest species.
Yeah?
It's the leaves of before they got central spines.
Wow. This is a wealth of information here. Which one is this? Can you point that out again, Olivia? Is it this one? Okay. This one here. Wow.
Chinese. You see, it's before central spines developed. Each leaf is sprayed out, as it were.
Mm-hmm.
I love the ginkgo. Nice, and got a nice Chinese here. There's a lovely fan pot. You might notice they make themselves fur coats.
Do they? Oh, yes, I see on the trunk there, right? They do.
Yeah. They
Tear
that off, they die.
Oh, is that right? That's their insulation and conductivity and everything, huh? What a beautiful specimen. That's really gorgeous. Look at that. Down this beautiful tree-lined path. Different types of trees and shrubs, and completely different character than the line of the yew trees. Gives you a different feeling.
This is our growth here.
Wow.
They're doing things to feed at the moment.
Uh-huh. Look at that.
The doorway, the two feet face our
doorway. Uh-huh. Okay.
And this is our grove.
Oh, yes. Look at this grove of trees here, Mare. Like a magic circle.
It's useful for ritual.
Uh-huh.
It's come together powerful.
It's one of the ritual grove places typical, isn't it? Beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. Mm-hmm. Look at the height of these trees. Wow. Wow.
Dedicated to Tara.
Tara?
Mm.
Uh-huh.
The name of Diana and Tara may all be blessed.
Wow. That's gorgeous. There's something very special about a grove.
I love a grove. Yes.
It's beautiful.
Two druids here yesterday.
Wow.
We did a little ceremony.
Oh, really? Wow. With you or on their own, Olivia?
Yes.
Did they do the ceremony themselves or with you?
Oh, we did it together.
Right.
People, when they are here, don't do their own ceremonies. I always join in because I'm the guardian of the place.
Very good. Okay. Thanks. have to get these things straight.
Oh, yeah. I always get them straight.
There's different feelings here, all right. Every which way you go.
Actually, I think, now you said it, I do think it's a bit funny, the old cow shed. I never thought it in my paper before. But you know these nightmare commentators?
Right? Oh, no, no. Well, they do it for badness. That's a difference. Oh. That's a difference.
Oh, no, they mean well. It used to be when I was a kid, Pathé Gazette.
Uh-huh.
In those days.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Then they do it now.
Uh-huh. Look at this. Absolutely gorgeous. I wonder what these steps lead up to here. Wonder what that means.
This leads up. It's actually that has a white parapet and a lake and a river.
Uh-huh.
This has the old Druid Abbey.
Uh-huh.
That way is Mount Leinster. And this way, the little summer house.
Uh-huh.
It was an old summer house. We rebuilt it.
Wow.
And a temple it used to be called.
Uh-huh. So many pathways and axes.
Yes.
Look at this.
It's laid out in about 1680 on the French model because the chap came back with a restoration.
Uh-huh.
Sir Lawrence Desmond, and they laid it all out. And that's what interested Stanley Kubrick, because the Desmond film his film was based on Thackeray's Barry Lyndon,
uh-huh.
but who wrote Henry Desmond, based on the story of our family, really.
My goodness.
Yes, too long story to tell now, but...
Well, Kubrick did a great job on...
Have you seen it then?
Oh, yes.
He was wandering around, he filmed the temple, everything was in sight.
Amazing, isn't it?
He wandered around, that amazing camera of his, like his eye.
That's right. Mm. Uh-huh, yeah, it's like it was part of him. Wow.
We rebuilt what we used to call the lily pond. We found that was rather nice.
Uh-huh.
Isn't it fun?
Oh, yes. Look at this. This is a part of the ritual route and everything that you and I have never seen, Mary.
Gorgeous, isn't it?
It's gorgeous, yes. In a very different sense. Wow. Different feelings every which way you turn here. Different feelings. And thank goodness the rain stopped today. I know, it's gorgeous. Look at the way it falls here. That's really magnifico.
It's a lovely old iron.
Wow. She says she used to roll down this embankment when she was a kid around 8 years old. Must have been fun. It's still here. Isn't that great? And no trouble making it up either, Olivia.
Castle built 1625.
Right.
And bits of the 14th century at the far end and 18th century, the wings. Victorian Conservatory.
18th century, the wings?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, all early, Queen Anne. That is the ant, you see.
Uh-huh, right, I can
there,
see that.
And you see, comes out, and then it's two sides, one to the left-hand part of the wilderness, the other up to the abbey.
Uh-huh.
And then the shaft of the ant is the avenue.
Uh-huh.
That was the old way it used to be. They didn't do it because of that, but they just liked it.
Right. But it came out that way, huh?
Yes.
Well, you can see the Ankh design now anyway. As you step back, and the higher you go in the air, of course, then you would see how...
You better go up the three steps of the castle
there. Right. She doesn't want me to trip over those three steps. Look at this. Yeah, you can definitely get a better view of that symbolism. That's right, you do. Beautiful.
Tips of the mild of earth they're using for gravel.
Uh-huh. Yes, a lot of it. This is very soft, high-piled gravel. Century. Wow.
Well, so the archaeologist Liesk said.
Uh-huh.
But the rest is sort of added on to look romantic.
Of course.
And we use it for ceremonies. Oh, it's lovely up there. Then it fell down, so we rebuilt that.
Oh, yes.
We just stuck it up again. In the name of Dana, may all beings be good.
Very much so. Lovely. Look at this. Look at this through here, though. This is great.
Yeah, that is nice, isn't it?
Yeah, there really is that archway. Yeah.
Yeah.
Archways are beautiful.
I love that one. You see the castle through it.
Uh huh. Look at this archway here, honey. Mm. Look at that. I'm talking to my wife on this camera a bit.
Oh, that, yeah, I gathered that. It makes it more real.
It helps a lot to for her to see it this way. No, for her. Oh, you like this, Mama. This is a fairy thorn. You're not allowed to cut a fairy thorn. Can you see that, huh? It's a real fairy thorn. I have to make a wish by going around from left to right. So I'm doing this. Fairy circle around the tree and making my wish as I dance around the well. I think like we all know what the wish might be. Thank you.
Ancient, well, 100-year-old wall hangings, Caro,
right.
Hangings from an old castle. There's Anubis guarding the way.
Mm-hmm.
She was here before, but this is a lovely new one.
Wow. Down into the temple itself again.
Isn't she lovely? This
is
a new
one.
She's nice and black, the goose. And she reflects herself into our African place here. You see, you come down
right,
and you see the African figures and her.
So then
you're in it. You better stand up.
So the Nubian thing, huh?
Because if you stand right back and out of it, you're not in the picture. And this is different too.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Wow. This is our fairy one, Osiris and her, but they're in their winged form.
Right.
You see, all this, because this is the fairy.
It is nice, yes.
That's because he was
that's lovely.
On this earth when we were off there. And this is, I love her, Deceito. This is, and these are very ancient Irish heads, those. They go way back, pre-Christian, you know, the ancient Celtic heads.
Mm-hmm.
The goddess. And the well, you know the well anyway.
Oh, yes, Bridget's well.
Bridget's well.
Oh, yes, lovely.
You can have a splash of water.
Right.
And, but I have some water, holy water. There you are.
Thank you.
This is my favourite new arrival, Tara, of the southeast and of Ireland. Isn't she beautiful?
Uh huh.
I love her.
Very nice.
Mm.
Lovely.
Now, this is the fair, this place you've been in before, haven't you? This is Donna.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
You remember all this?
I do, yes.
But in there, it's the same thing. It's the...
Wow. This is a very special tour I'm getting here, sweetheart, let me tell you.
This is the golden thing of Dala. I saw a vision of her like that. The two visionaries.
Uh-huh.
You see them all together, because I did, as you see it later, a Maya. But this lady I met, and she came from a spaceship, this one. She's made a crystallized
met
light.
This one.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
But she, in her spirit form, she just appeared, you know.
Right.
So that's the one obvious ET person. Yet she was spiritual, not physical. And
Desmond says they all work together. They're all part of it.
I shouldn't be surprised. Yeah, I agree, rather.
Mm. Interesting, isn't it?
Mm. Glad to have introduced you to her.
Thank you.
Once you do. my hair set, and you see her in, you see, I love those people, they're all...
Oh, I know you do.
That's different, they're all papyri. It is, three goddesses now, there was only one before.
Wow, this is especially indirect lighting in here. It's very, very interesting when you first enter into here, because there's there's such an oval feeling to this room, isn't there?
Yes, the old dungeon. Hello, Steve.
Wow, the old dungeon. With the only escape route out through that small hole, if you can make it that small. Look at that.
Now, sort of showing him round the three goddesses head. Have you met Tara?
Wow.
Oh, I haven't.
Wow. Well. Amazing, huh? So many things. So many things. My goodness.
She's adorable. I love her. Now, this is Cancer.
Uh-huh.
You see how different she is, all white.
Oh, yes.
Now we come to...
Doing the zodiac here.
Yeah, well, we'll do the zodiac. We'll go through this here, we'll zoom the zodiac.
Okay.
This is our Indian place. This is rather different now, because we've got this sort of Indian stuff around.
Right.
A little bit more.
Uh-huh.
And since my brother's demise, here we've got creatress of all
this
life.
Is Nukua, the Chinese goddess of creation.
Yeah, she creates us all out of yellow, white, and red clay, that kind of stuff.
Uh-huh.
You've done Lakshmi, haven't you?
Look at this. Where's Kwan... What's her name? Kwan Yang.
Where is she? I don't think she's around, really.
Oh, right.
At the moment.
Oh, she was the goddess of compassion, wasn't she? In beauty or something?
Yeah, I hear she's seen...
Kwan Yin.
Yeah, that Kwan Yang, yeah, she could be there.
Could represent that, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
It's actually meant to be the Virgin Mary.
Uh-huh.
A sort of Japanese version.
Right.
She's...
Why not?
Now, this is a favorite. You go in on your own. It's so beautiful. I love this. Yes, I'll take off my coat so you see me introducing her properly.
Right, this is the healing chapel here.
This is the winged Isis. We hail the winged Isis, who drew her husband from death into life as the winged Horus. So we're all meant to be growing wings.
Right.
There she is. There's Orion. Sirius.
Mm-hmm. Sirius on one side and Orion, that's
yes,
right.
Yes, Orion, Sirius.
That's right.
Side.
That's the whole mystery there, all right.
Yes, this is it.
It's beautiful. The whole mythos in this one little chapel, healing room.
That's the idea. It's right. Very good for healing.
Wow. Very nice. Strange ghosts as well.
Did you say, no, you're Aquarius.
Aquarius, yeah.
Gemini, and there's all our members, you see. There's a lady with... Because she's like frozen copper-coloured light. Copper-coloured.
Wow.
But I just put gold paint, but it doesn't give you an idea.
No.
She's right across the sky, which is a bit hot.
My goodness. Yeah, this is from the Hopi, definitely from the Hopi tribe and their legends.
Yes, they gave it.
And their beliefs with the corn maiden.
Yes.
And the different...
Marlin.
Well, Cochina.
Cochina. Says, I've been up there, Sacred Mountain, San Francisco Range, and
invoked
the goddess, and she came through in the form of a pillar of light, right through me.
My goodness.
That's why I think they have totem poles. It's a great pillar of light, quite different from the way other goddesses appear.
Well, that's the ancient pagan, isn't it? The tower.
I didn't know that.
Uh-huh.
Well, I was up on this mountain, and we didn't want to go sort of poaching North American Indian religion. We want to do our own, so we invoked the goddess, and that happened.
No, but the similarities are amazing.
So, and then we went down to Flagstaff, and again she came to our Halloween setup as a pillar of light.
My goodness.
So that would be the tower. That's fascinating.
Yeah, the tower.
I knew that's what she has a...
Oh, you see now...
My nephew designed that.
Mm-hmm.
David. And behind you see the solar, and then the mirror is the moon. She is Earth, Sun, and Moon.
Right.
Vashed. She has these...
And this is my wife's sign as well.
Oh, well, she'll like that.
Yes, and we have an admission from the priestess...
I mean, you have that in the other...
That it's her sign as well.
Now, it is very funny. The great spiral galaxy, Andromeda, here, she's between... Pisces and Aries, and there it is, a sort of little thing in there, sort of mysterious Andromeda. And then you come, William Morris, the great artist, he did those things for another castle, actually, but we've got them now, and Pisces. Now, I wonder if you can show the eternal nature of mirror magic here. You see that grail, that cup?
Yes.
Well, if you fill it with water, it multiplies. If you put wheat there, it multiplies. Could you look right through, bring your camera right in and see if you can film what is to the, how it's mirror magic. Everything there multiplies.
Does it?
No, go right up to it and peer down. No, right.
Okay, I'm going to try.
No, you can't. You've got to go right in. I'm sorry.
I know, but I'm going to try to go in by, by getting down on a crouch, you see.
Oh, I see. Creep in, right up to it, and then you turn to the left and the right. Right up, no further up. It's no good.
Oh, the mirror, I see.
You've got to go right in.
I'm going in.
Ah,
look at that. Oh, my goodness, yes. Look at that.
It's how to multiply.
It is certainly, yes. That's fertility, all right.
Yeah, we're going to do that for the coming new age.
It's coming.
You see?
Look at this.
You can multiply anything. Loaves of bread, fishes, grapes.
Isn't this fantastic, huh?
Ideas, a candle. The walls are so thick, that's why. You could, have you got your lighter, or do you want to do a candle?
Oh, we could see, yeah, we could see how that candle does.
Yeah, well, have you got a lighter on it?
Yeah, oh, yeah, I do. The Ark of the Covenant type of representation here.
Inside, you'll see Isis inside. You could film inside the...
Can I?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
You can see Isis and Osiris, and it says it's the death shrine. And the winged Isis.
I see that, yeah.
That's a real crystal in there.
Wow.
Genuine.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah, so then you gradually hone your way into the other then.
And I've lit this candle, as my wife has lit a candle for this visit that I was going on with Olivia today. And we're going to take a look and see how this multiplies, the flame. Look at that. Row upon row upon row.
Imagine what it's like when you light all the candles.
Yes.
Well.
I can imagine. Oh, that's great. It's fantastic.
Are you able to film it?
Oh, yes.
Great.
Oh, yeah, it comes out fine.
This might be nice for film. Like to light that.
Okay.
Which is nice.
Oh, this is nice.
Yeah, that is the Isis.
Wow.
This is the wrapper. If you like, I'll invoke Isis so as to give
will
it. Will
you?
Yeah, I will, why not?
My goodness. This is a special, very special thing.
Yeah, I will. But what is your intention? What do you want me to do it for? I know, we'll call Steve.
Yes.
Would you like to come and do an invocation for his film, the two of you? Now, what do you want to do in this film that you would like a good cause or some intention you have to bless?
Do you want me to say it out loud?
Yeah, you tell me. Yeah, it better be an outside, out loud thing, because then we'll know.
Okay, we want higher energy in the world. How's that?
Higher energy for good.
For good, of course.
Yeah, because we are never always, of course. Now, would you like to come around, both of you? That's fine. And I think to make you look dramatic as a priest, we'll just break this, wait a minute, behind you, you know, it'll look like a sort of cloak.
Oh, I'm sorry if you have to. No, it's fine.
That was very good.
Wow.
Well, we come off the platform, face it, and then each of us come forward, and then we give our blessing to the world. I will invoke Isis, and who would you like to invoke?
I'll invoke Calypso.
No, a god, I think.
Oh, a god, okay. I'll invoke Mercury.
Mercury, and who will you invoke?
I'll invoke Amorigon.
Right. Well, that's lovely. Now, I may make a horrible noise, but I'll have a bit of music. It'll get us into the right mood music. It's very gently in the background. I invoke the goddess Isis, goddess of the whole world, daughter of Nui of the galaxy, to bless us at the dawn of the Aquarian age. Especially we have an honored guest among us whose intention is that we should strengthen the energies of the world for good. I call upon the priest, that his name among the Navajo Indians is
Himloa.
I call upon the priest to invoke deity.
I invoke the god Mercury, who is Lu. I ask him for his guidance and his blessings for us on this earth, that we may respect the earth and have earth consciousness, and that we are no longer three-dimensional beings, but all the nine and all the 13-dimensional human beings. Good Mercury.
I invoke the goddess on Maragon, goddess of strength, goddess of Scotia, goddess of Era, uniter of peoples, and uniter of male and female principles. May she bring healing and may she be healed as she needs to be healed, and may she join with us now in our quest for a higher world energy and a higher world power for good, and for creativity and for strength. Gomeate.
Gomeate. Now.
Wow.
While I hold the camera.
I'm a guest here and I'm very honored that Olivia will have me do my own invocation. I've asked the Yebeche, the Navajo gods, for higher resonance to be brought to this planet so that each may become capable of what they are becoming. Let each become all they are capable of becoming. Let this new resonating energy pour forth for the coming age, for the swinging of eras. Ne yebeche. Denez batis ba'ahaya. What's the closing thing that you say?
Gomete.
Thank you.
Divine Isis of 10,000 names, we give you thanks for your blessing, for our devoted work at this dawn of the millennium of Aquarius, and that you have heard and answered our prayers that we may, through the Navajo Nation, increase the Earth's energy for good. May all beings be blessed. The she and humans, animals, birds, reptiles, fishes, insects, trees, plants, this earth, and the mighty star beings who are now amongst us.
I thank the god Mercury for his presence here today. This is his time of year, and I ask him to guide us amongst all the new dimensional beings that we journey to wherever we are chosen to journey to, and that our paths may be that of enlightenment. Live long and prosper, journey well.
So notably.
I'm doing this properly. That it may be united with the male principle, and that it may bring about healing and love for each person and each living being. Gomeke.
Let us go forward.
That's lovely. It's very nice.
Well, I can't believe how synchronicity happens. I mean, here we all are here, we're making this beautiful video. A priest, a priestess turn up in order to give us a ritual, a blessing for your wonderful intention. Because I've been with Navajos and with Hopis too, and I know that the seeds of the future in their prophecies. So thanks all of you.
And thank you all from me. Thank you very much. Look at this time, will you? Uh-huh. For Black Beauty. Let's see if I can open this door here, huh? There you go. Magnetic.